Well, thousands, of course, have gathered to protest Australia Day at Invasion Day rallies across the country.
Always was, always will be Aboriginal land!
Always was, always will be!
Now, the record swell of support has exposed a different division, with many speaking out against the proposal for an Indigenous voice to Parliament.
Do we want to become an advisory body to the colonial system?
No!
We deserve better than that!
Marcus Stewart is a proud Ngira Ilimbolic man of the Tungurung Nation and joins us now. Marcus, why didn't you attend a rally today?
Well, I'm pretty disappointed I couldn't be there today. I'm actually quite sad. It would have been my son's first rally to march in solidarity, to get around our community and catch up with my family. But a couple of weeks ago, the rally took a different direction of where posters were up around it being Treaty Before Voice, and it appeared to become a bit of a soft launch of a no campaign, and it went completely against my values. I'm a strong yes believer. I believe in voice. And unfortunately, for the first time in a long time, I couldn't be there today with my community, with my family and with our allies in solidarity. But I'll certainly be there next year.
You've probably seen some of the pictures from the rallies around the country today. What did you make of some of the messaging at the rallies?
Yeah, the turnout was amazing, which is great. I mean, because you think about it, this is a phenomenal movement that's been happening for quite a long time now. And to get where it is just a credit to how the organisers have brought that movement forward. So I think it's quite important to acknowledge how far this movement has come, even the cancellation of the Australia Day parade. But some of the messaging around Treaty Before Voice, and I think about some of the work I've done here in Victoria through the First Peoples Assembly of Victoria around treaty and around truth-telling, and we would have never have got there or delivered or made history like we have if it wasn't for voice. And I think that's forgotten in the debate, that for us to progress treaty in this country, we need voice.
Understanding that you can't speak for them, why do you think some Indigenous people are so opposed to the voice?
We have a difference of opinion and views, and that's the beauty of our community. We're not a homogenous group. We like to have a debate. We don't always agree, but I think we should be held to the same democratic standards of our fellow Australian, and that's that we can disagree, we can have a debate. And I think, you know, there's an opportunity to not only bring our fellow Australian along with understanding exactly what the voice is and what it can achieve, but also our community to unpack what a moment in time we are right now, and we're on the verge of history of, you know, potentially constitutionally enshrining a voice to Parliament to improve the lives of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, and we can't lose sight of that.
You wrote an article about all this today. In it, it was interesting because you called the people who'd kind of taken over this protest, you called them wreckers. What exactly do you say they're wrecking?
Well, they reckon the greatest opportunity for self-determination our people have seen, certainly in my lifetime, and an opportunity to improve the lives of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people around the country through voice, through being heard, through bringing voice to the voiceless of our communities. And basically, the voice gives us an opportunity to reach into every corner of this great country to understand the complexity of the issue and actually bring that advice and thread the eye of a needle through any government or parliament of the day to understand what policies, legislation are disproportionately impacting our people. We're sick of hearing all the closing the gap data that's supposed to shape our life, and I think voice really provides us that greatest opportunity to improve the lives of our people and be the tide that raises all ships.
It's fair to say it hasn't been a great week for the Voice Yes campaign. We've seen the criticism from the opposition, we've seen the messages at the rallies that you're talking about. Do you think it's going to succeed?
I do, because I believe in the Australian people, I believe in my community, and I believe that people want to improve the lives of Aboriginal people across this country. It's disappointing that we've seen a significant amount of immaturity from our politicians, but it's sort of what we've come to expect over the last couple of years. But we hope now that we can, you know, the political football can be put down, we can come together and we can look at how we can best collaborate and design a voice that will improve the lives of Aboriginal people around this country.
Okay, Marcus, thank you so much for your time tonight.
Thank you.